Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Cortland and we are here with another movie review. This time we're doing Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri. All right, so originally this movie was only available to a small audience and then gradually it was released everywhere else, and I think it's still playing in theaters currently. So if it is in your theaters, you should go check it out. But anyways, this is one of those Oscar-y type movies where it's like definitely going to be nominated for a bunch of stuff and whatnot, that type of movie. But honestly, I have to say, it didn't impress me as much as I thought it would have, but that's just me. Basically, what this movie is about is this mother who lives in the small town with her son, and she's trying to basically pin the blame on the police department in the town that she lives in for not catching her daughter's rapist and killer, which that's what this whole entire story revolves around. Is that one little plot point, and a bunch of different things happen, yada yada yada. But anyways, one funny thing about this movie is that it was actually filmed in the town that I live in, or live close to anyway. There's like a bunch of small towns all put together in one area, and that's just one of the towns. But yeah, it was filmed in Silva, North Carolina, which is pretty much where I live, and that just kind of made this movie a little bit more, it felt more at home to me, like watching it. It felt very familiar and it was just easy to get into and watch because I have lived here for 3 or 4 years now, so I'm very familiar with the town and everything. But with that being said, it also hit me on a more personal level than what most people would be feeling when watching this movie because of how the story went and whatnot. I'm not really going to get into that because that's a personal thing, but it made me cry a little bit. It made me get a little emotionally attached to the movie. So with that, the movie did a good job, at least. It made me connect with it, which is something not many movies can do nowadays. Like, you need to, I think that's what movies are for. They need to try to, like, connect with their audience in different ways and just make them appreciate the different things in there. Like, I think I'm explaining this right. But anyways, like, Black Panther is a good example of this, with it being released in February, and that's Black History Month, and it's like a celebration of their culture, and a lot of people in that culture would be very happy when that movie finally gets released. So like something like that. That's what I mean. But anyways, so overall, I enjoyed this movie a lot. It wasn't the best thing in the world, certainly. I don't think it deserves as much credit as it does, because I feel like the plot of this movie, like, the writing and whatnot, it just, meh. It didn't really resolve in a good way. I feel like the visuals and whatnot are really good, but it's something I've already seen, to be quite honest. It's nothing new to me personally, because I've seen all the scenery and whatnot in the town that it was filmed in. So it's just like, it wasn't really breathtaking or anything. It's just something like, yeah, I've seen that already. Still fun to look at, but the only real thing that stands out in this movie are the actors and their performances. I really enjoyed Sam Rockwell's character in this one. I really like Sam Rockwell, to be quite honest with you. He's a really good actor. And Woody Harrelson is in this movie too. He's pretty good, but his character I didn't really connect with this character that much. Sam Rockwell's character I really connected with, to be honest. On a personal level, his performance stood out the most to me. But yeah, overall, pretty good movie. I'd recommend seeing it, definitely. It's rated R, so don't take kids to see it. There's a lot of language and whatnot in here. That's for sure. It's not the best movie for them. But yeah, it should be in theaters. Definitely go check it out if you can. It's one of the better movies of 2017. I'd say it's a 2017 movie, even though its wide release was early in January of this year. But quick score, I forgot to put that in there. I'd give it an 8.5 out of 10. I enjoyed it, but it still wasn't the best thing in the world. Hope you guys enjoyed this review. If you did, leave a like, leave a comment. Tell me what you thought of the movie if you've seen it, and if you haven't seen it, go check it out if you can. And make sure to subscribe to this channel to see more movie reviews come out by me and see other things that come out on this channel. Stay awesome. Grrr.